Welcome to this video on explainable AI. Imagine you are a medical professional and that you are using AI for stroke prediction. And the AI has predicted stroke for one of your patients. Now, when you tell this to your patient, he is going to panic. And there are two obvious questions which he will ask. The first, can you explain why the stroke is predicted? And the second, what can be done to avoid it? In order to answer these questions, you will need explainable AI. And this is necessary for various other domains such as credit trace, product recommendations, and many others. So in this video, I'll be demonstrating explainable AI using the techniques shown on the screen. I'll be explaining them with examples and visuals, and there's no complex programming screens. So whatever your profession, you can just sit back, relax, and enjoy the videos. You can also experience some of the data science techniques demonstrated on this channel on the channel's website, experiencedatascience.com. The link is in the description below. I would also like to advertise a request which I have received from a group of engineering students in France who have developed a mobile application which can help international students to find educational institutes in an easy and efficient way. This app will allow you to find educational institutes using various criteria. It can be used by students aspiring to study in France as well as schools looking for partnership with other schools. This app is called IDSUP and is available on Apple as well as Android. The link is in the description below. So friends, now let's get started with explainable AI. But do not forget to subscribe to the channel, like and comment the video. In this video, we will take a patient who is a male and 67 years of age. He has a medical history of heart disease, an average glucose level of 228 and a body mass index of 37. And artificial intelligence has made the prediction that this patient will suffer a stroke. Now, as a medical professional, you will have to be ready to explain the prediction to the patient. So let us start with different techniques which will help you to do so. Let us start with a simple data visualization technique. To start with, we can take the data which was used to train the AI. This data is on various other patients where we actually know if the patient suffered a stroke or no. We can then use the data visualization techniques to understand why a stroke occurs. And one of the very useful data visualization techniques is radar chart, which is shown here. The orange area corresponds to the patients who have suffered a stroke, and the blue area corresponds to the patients who have not suffered a stroke. The difference between the two areas gives us an insight into the reasons for a stroke. We observe that the patients who had a stroke have a high glucose level, have a heart disease, have hypertension, are relatively high in the age, and have formerly smoked. Now, this gives us a good understanding of the reasons for a stroke. Now we can compare this with our patient's situation. And we see that the patient is fulfilling most of the conditions which would lead to a stroke. And this can help us to explain why the patient is at risk. Though this is a very simple way, we do not know which of the stroke-causing factors are more important than others. So let us now look into the second technique which will help us solve this problem. The AI which was used to predict the stroke is based on a machine learning model. You can use these models to explain the stroke prediction. There are various machine learning models and I'll be demonstrating the following three models. Let us start with the logistic regression model. The result of a logistic regression model is shown on the screen. On the y-axis, you have different factors and on the x-axis, you have the importance of the factors for a stroke condition. The blue bar indicates the factors which lead to a stroke and the red bar shows the factors which will help in avoiding a stroke. So for example, the age, working for a private company, high glucose levels, heart disease and hypertension can result into a stroke. And being married, being self-employed, living in rural areas can reduce the probability of having stroke. Now for our patient, we have a stroke predicted with 74.8% probability. Now let us try to explain why by clicking the button explain. We now see a light gray bar appearing which indicates the patient information with respect to these factors. We see that the patient's age, his private work, glucose level and his heart conditions are factors which explain why he is at the risk of stroke. His body mass index or BMI is low and not a reason for a potential stroke. Now, this is more accurate way compared to the earlier radar plot technique, as we are now precise on which are the top factors leading to a potential stroke. Logistic regression models are an excellent way to explain any predictions, as it helps us to identify which factors are more important than others. For example, here we know that the patient's glucose level is more important than the patient's body mass index for the stroke prediction. However, what exactly is the glucose level which is leading the patient to a potential stroke? Let us answer this question using the decision tree model. Here is the result of the decision tree model. This model has got different decision nodes shown as black points. These decision nodes indicate a field and a threshold value. And the final node is whether the patient will have stroke or no. Now let us try to explain the prediction of our patient by clicking on explain. You will see a path which goes through different decision nodes. Now we can analyze the decision nodes in this path and understand why the stroke is predicted. For example, an age less than 67.5 is a decision node. Paths going up indicate a yes and paths going down indicate a no. As the patient age is 67, which is less than 67.5, the path is going up. The next decision node is glucose level less than 104.47. The path is going down as the glucose level for the patient is 228.69, which is more than 104.47. And then this path then ultimately leads to a stroke prediction as yes. So we know now that a glucose level of more than 104.47 is going to cause a potential stroke. This is more precise than the logistic regression model earlier shown. This can also help in advising the patient on the glucose level and take necessary actions to reduce it below 104.47. Thus, we are not only explaining the reasons for a potential stroke, but we are also advising the patient on the steps to take to reduce the risk. Now let us move to neural network machine learning models. Neural network algorithms are inspired on how our brain works. On the left hand side, you have the input neurons, which are different characteristic of the patient. On the right hand side, you have the output neurons. The neurons 2-0 indicates no stroke and 2-1 indicates a stroke. And in the middle, you have the intermediate neurons, which are connecting the input neurons and the output neurons. Each of these neurons sends a positive signal and a negative signal to other neurons. Positive signal is indicated by a gray line and the negative signal is indicated by a red line. Now let us try to explain the prediction of our patient by clicking on explain. You see the neuron 1-4 is strongly activated, shown here by a thick green circle. And this node is sending a negative signal towards no stroke neuron. This means that the patient has high probability of stroke. Now let us peek inside the neuron 1-4. And this is how the inside of the neuron looks like. The radar plot is based on input neurons and the signals received from them. We see very high signals from input neurons for glucose level, heart disease and age. So these are the conditions which are leading to a stroke prediction. These explanations are similar to what we have obtained using earlier models. Now all the three models give similar explanations. However, the way in which the models are interpreted is very different. So enter SHAP. SHAP stands for Shapley Additive Explanations. It is capable of explaining any model. This helps in having a single approach to understanding the predictions irrespective of the machine learning model used. The shape of our stroke predictions is shown on the screen. You see two vertical dotted lines. The gray dotted line corresponds to the expected probability that a stroke can happen to any patient in the data. We see that this is approximately 50%, and this is due to the fact that in the data which was used for machine learning, about 50% of patients have stroke and 50% do not have stroke. The red dotted line corresponds to our patient, and this line is at 74.8%, as our patient has 74.8% probability of stroke. The horizontal bars represent the different factors and how they add up from moving the patient from 50% to 74.8% probability of stroke. We see that the age is contributing 15% to the probability of stroke. Glucose level is contributing 10% to the probability of stroke, and BMI is contributing 4.4% to the probability of stroke. Because we know the contribution of each factor to the probability of stroke, we can use this analysis for any advice to the patient. The age of the patient cannot be changed, but if the average glucose level and the body mass index can be reduced, then the risk of the stroke goes down from 74.8 to almost about 60%. So we are able to explain the predictions, but also we are able to advise what can be done to reduce the risk and by how much. Hope you have liked the video. Thank you for watching, and do not forget to subscribe to the channel, like and comment on the video.